Hello everyone, I, Supriya Nikam. Today I am going to discuss the MCQs under the topic State of Matter and the Properties of Matter. This chapter is included in the syllabus of SYB Pharm under the subject Physical Pharmaceutics 1. So now we are going to start with the MCQs. A gas will be approaches the ideal behavior at high temperature, low pressure, low temperature, high pressure, then high temperature, low pressure, high temperature, high pressure, and the answer will be high temperature and low pressure. Second, according to the kinetic theory of gases, in an ideal gas between the two successive collision, a gas molecule travels in a wavy path, in a straight line path, C with the accelerated velocity, and D in a circular path. As we all know, the gas molecules always will be following will be the straight line between the two successive collisions. So answer will be the straight line. The maximum deviation from the ideal gas is expected from H2, BN2, C, CH4. And D, NH3, and so answer will be the maximum deviation from the ideal gas will be expected from the NH3 gas. Fourth question, if a gas expands at a constant temperature, it indicates that a number of molecules of gas increases, kinetic of energy of molecules decreases, the pressure of the gas increases, and the kinetic energy of the molecule remains the same. So as we know, the gas expands at constant temperature, so there will not be change in the kinetic energy. So the answer will be the D, that is the kinetic energy of molecule remains the same. Fifth question, the Dalton's law of the partial pressure is applicable to which one of the following system? That is A option, CO plus H2, B H2 plus Cl2, C option Na plus O2, and D option NH3 plus HCl. So as we know, the answer will be CO plus H2. Sixth question, in order to increase the volume of gas by 10%, the pressure of the gas should be. So just remember, in order to increase the volume of gas by 10%, so here we have to increase the gas volume of gas. So option A, increase by 10%, B, increase by 1%, C, decrease by 10%, and D will be decrease by 1%. So as we know, if you have to increase the volume, you have to decrease the pressure. So the option or the answer will be C, that is decrease by 10%. 1 mole of oxygen at 273 Kelvin and 1 mole of sulfur dioxide at 546 Kelvin. So are taken in two separate containers. Then the kinetic energy of O2 will be greater than the kinetic energy of SO2. Option B, the kinetic energy of O2 is less than the kinetic energy of SO2. Option number C, kinetic energy of both are equal. And the last option, none of the above. So as we know, the temperature of oxygen is less than that of the sulfur dioxide. That means the kinetic energy of O2 will be less as compared to the kinetic energy of SO2. So the answer will be the B, that is the kinetic energy of O2 is less than the kinetic energy of SO2. Then 8, in the two vessels of 1 liter each at the same temperature. So 1 liter each and the same temperature. Okay. And 1 gram of H2 and 1 gram of CH4 are taken. For this, VR MS value will remain same. Kinetic energy per mole will be same, total kinetic energy will be same, or pressure will be the same. So answer definitely will be the kinetic energy per mole will remain the same. Phenomena in which a substance exists in more than one form. So it's a very simple answer. Option is A, crystalline, B, polymorphism, C, anisotropic, and the polycrystallinity. So answer will be definitely will be the polymorphism, because in polymorphism the substance exists in more than one form. So answer is polymorphism. Again, next simple question, polymorphism refers to the compounds having different crystal structure, different stereochemistry, different composition, and D, all of the above. So answer very simple, A, that is a different crystalline structure, because in polymorphism the polymorph having a different crystal structure than each other. 11th question, the amorphous form of drug dissolves dash as compared to the crystalline form. Option A, slower, B, faster, C, equal, and D, half. So as we all know, if we convert the crystalline form into the amorphous form, the dissolution process will be more faster. So answer will be the B, that is the faster. Question number 12, properties of amorphous solid. No crystal structure, no definite melting point, glassy, or all of the above. So as we know all, the amorphous solid does not having any crystal structure, it does not having a definite melting point, and it's a glassy as well. So answer will be the all of the above. Lindt's method of liquefaction is based on the adiabatic cooling, Joule-Thomas effect, cooling with the freezing mixture, or all of the above. So the answer will be a B, that is the Joule-Thomas effect. 14th question, the propellant are used in an aerosols too. It's again a very simple question. What is the use of this propellant in case of aerosols? So option will be A, for cooling, B, as an excipient, C, to create a pressure and decrease the pressure. So as we all know, the propellant are used in case of aerosol to create a pressure, okay, so that it can it will remain in the form. 15th question, the heat needed to change a state of matter is A, the latent heat, B, the vapor heat, C is the fusion heat, and D is the condensation. So as we all know, the heat which are required to convert to change state one state of matter to another is the latent heat. So answer will be the A, that is the latent heat. Characteristics of solid, ability to diffuse, B, indefinite volume, C, definite volume, and D, indefinite shape. So as we know, the solid is having a definite volume, okay, and all other properties are not of the solid. So the answer will be the definite volume, that is option C. 17th question, what is the state of matter is a water, solid, liquid, gas, and D is all of the above. So as we all know, the water exists in both of all of these three phases or state of matter. So answer is the D, that is all of the above. 18th question, changing from one state of matter to another is a dash change. So whether it's A, that is a chemical change, B, physical change, C, nuclear change, or D, none. So as we all know, changing a state of matter is just a physical change. It does not change its chemical or nuclear. So the answer will be the physical one. That is an option B. Gases have no weight. Whether it's a true or false. So it's a very simple and logical question. The answer definitely will be the gas having no weight. The answer will be the false, because as we all know, the gas having a weight, right? 20th and last question, the solids are called dash if solid is their particles are arranged in a repeated three-dimensional pattern, which calls crystal, A, crystalline, B, amorphous, C, both, and D, none. So it's a very simple question. Again, the answer will be the crystalline, because in a crystalline solid, these particles are arranged in a repeatedly three-dimensional pattern. So answer will be the A, that is a crystalline. So these are the 20 questions under the topic state of matter and properties of matter. I hope this video will be helpful for you.